evening, brothers and sisters. Good evening, brothers and sisters. Good evening, friends. Good evening, in-laws. And good evening, outlaws. I'm just so happy to be back in Grass. I love this city. I love the landscape. I love the people. And I love elevate. And I believe we have to elevate everything to save the planet. We have to elevate our engagements, elevate our politics, elevate the arts, elevate our solidarity. You know, the connections between the issues that this festival brings up are so intricate and so vital. And I, in my experience, have seen that the arts actually build the platforms for political action and for the protection of the planet and all the relatives that we have on the planet. Songs provide the basis for waking up people and raising consciousness. Of course, I use poetry in my campaigns, paintings, and all this. And there's some, you know, there's been challenges. But growing up as an activist, there are some songs that so much have inspired me and still influence me. A song like Bob Marley's Redemption Song. Emancipate yourself from mental slavery, not but ourselves can free our mind. And then he goes on to say, how long shall we stand and watch while they kill the prophets? They're killing our prophets. How long shall they kill our prophets while we stand aside and look? You know, we just say, well, this is somebody else doing something that we stand aside. No, we cannot. I think this is the essence of this gathering in this festival, to remind ourselves that those who are producing the arts, the music, those who are leading the marches on the streets, then we all need to come together. Because when we are together, we are stronger. Can you say with me, together we are stronger? Together we are stronger. Yes. And indeed, the great Mandela said, it's an African saying, if you want to go fast, go alone. But if you want to go far, go together. And so this is a sense of global solidarity to tackle the existential issues of today. And what are the critical issues confronting the whole world today? The issues are not just confronting Africa, it's not confronting just Latin America or Asia, it's confronting Europe, North America, everyone. And these are two key issues, climate change and economic inequalities. The responses to this crisis have been to hem in, to close ourselves, and to restrict, to keep others away, to protect ourselves. But you know, when we stand alone, we can't really protect ourselves. When we stand alone, we end up opening up the space for the forces that have created the problems. And if you look back in history, you find that one of the most destructive forces on earth has been the forces of colonialism. But colonialism is still alive today. Our soils have been colonized, our waters have been colonized, our air is being colonized. Mother Earth colonized by capital, by forces of accumulation and forces of dispossession. And it's only by celebrating our strength in art, in music, in politics, that we can really deconstruct all these negative forces and then build the energy to construct the future that we want. I believe that the few moments we're going to be spending together this week will be a very vital moments, very vital moment to keep ourselves awake. Because, you know, if you've got a beautiful dream, you don't keep on sleeping so that the dream can continue. When you have a beautiful dream, you wake up and take action. When you have a beautiful dream, you wake up and take action. And this is what we need to do. This is what we need to do. I believe that this is the arena for dreams. We don't have time. We got to be quick. But we can't begin until we wake up. And I believe that this is time to see what the truth is. This is time to expose what is fake and let the fake be fake. Let the real be real, and let the truth be truth. So maybe you want to ask me, so what do I do now? I could just give you a simple answer. So well, as Bob Dylan sang, the answer is blowing in the wind. No, but I will not do that. I will not do that. We need to be concrete, right? We need to be concrete, right? And we are concrete by feeling ourselves, by getting to know who we are, by knowing that the pains of individuals in the global south are the same as the pains of individuals in the global north, that the oppressive forces in the south are the same oppressive forces in the north, that the wickedness of transnational corporations spread all over the world. And together we can confront these forces, and together we can construct the future that we want. And I believe that we all know the future we want. Future of liberty, equality, freedom. Future in which the rights of Mother Earth is respected. A future where ecocide is punished and all those destroying Mother Earth held to account. I thank you for welcoming me to Elevate 2019, and I look forward to coming back again.